Nightjar by Katya Balen. Narrated by Joe Jameson. Published by Barrington Stoke. Chapter 1. I wake up in the pink light of early morning. For a moment, I'm not sure why my eyes are open. There's a trilling in my ears, and in a dream haze, I panic. Has the tiny sparrow tucked away in a cosy shoebox in the bottom of my wardrobe escaped? The sleepiness trickles out of me like sand in a timer. I rub my eyes, and I remember my best friend Annie and I released the bird last week. It was just before she went away for a few weeks of summer music camp. The trilling gets louder and louder. I sit up, and I see the soft glow of my mobile phone. The screen is flashing. Dad calling, Dad calling, Dad calling. And the birdsong ringtone is fluttering around the room. I can almost imagine it spilling from the beaks of the birds on my wall. There are charcoal sketches swept in dusty lines on white paper, all the birds I've ever seen. One day, my whole room will be papered with them, and the dull magnolia walls will disappear completely behind a sea of feathers and talons. Dad calling, Dad calling, Dad calling. It must be midnight in New York, but Dad is always up late. He likes to watch sports games he's recorded on his massive TV, and catch up on emails, and eat takeout noodles in the dark quiet of his apartment. I've never actually been to his apartment, but he sends me pictures sometimes. When he first moved in, he video called me and carried his phone into every room so I could see the whole life he'd bought without me and Mum. You have to call it an apartment because it's in America, but also because it's different to my flat in about a million ways. It has huge glass windows and a view of the park. Dad says it's very important to have a view of the park if you live in New York. I once asked him what birds he could see in the park and from his windows that frame the whole sky. He just looked blankly at me from the computer screen and said something about pigeons. Dad calling, Dad calling, Dad calling. I can see blackbirds and crows and starlings and finches and sparrows and gulls and a thousand others from my small square window in my little flat. Once, I was watching for a nightjar because they're strange and beautiful and full of myths and secrets. Instead, I saw the wings of an owl beat in the star-dusted night air, and it was magic. So, I don't mind that Dad has a huge TV, and a view of the park, and a new girlfriend called Georgia, and an apartment 3,000 miles away, and a job that means he can only come and see me once a year. I've got everything I need right here. Just me, and Mum, and Annie, and the birds. The ones I've seen, and the ones I will see. Dad calling. Dad calling, Dad calling. I turn my phone over so the insistent message is shouting into my pillow. I roll over and I try to go back to sleep, just as the day birds start to sing. Chapter 2. Later that morning, I'm eating breakfast as fast as I possibly can without choking on toast and honey. I could be as slow as I like, because it's the summer holidays, but I want to go out and try to spot the woodpecker I know I heard yesterday. It was tapping its beak in a tree in the park, and the sound bounced into the clouds. So I'm matching my bites of toast to the fast click, click, click of Mum's sewing machine. The needle is flickering up and down like a silver fish darting into the waves of white fabric. Mum's making a tiny lace gown, and it's going to be beautiful. But it's also very terrible, because whenever Mum makes those gowns, it's not for a baby that's alive. She says it's an honour and a privilege to meet them. But I just think it's sad. Those little white gowns hang like ghosts in our flat until Mum delivers them to the hospital, wrapped in careful layers of soft tissue paper. Mum's phone pings, and she pauses the next tiny stitch to check it. I can tell by the way her eyebrows pull tight together that the email is from Dad. I think of the missed calls from earlier, and my phone's still buried under my pillow.
It's from your dad,
Mum says, but I already knew that. Her eyes scan down the blocks of text. There's a lot of it. Dad normally sends one line, like,
Happy birthday. Well done, champ. Georgia and I bought a kitten. See pic.
Dad doesn't have a lot to say to us, but that's okay. I never really know what to say to him either. Mum scrolls down the email, and the line of her eyebrows tightens.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.